been around since 76. My mom bought me a Raider sweater, put my name on it. I thought Brian was some type of unique name, so that's when because it was the name was on the sweater, they won the Super Bowl. I've been down ever since. So me and you about in the same boat. You're a year older than me, so that's what's up, man. Much love. But back to Ant, I don't think the Spurs gonna struggle, man. I think they gonna get back closer to the older Spurs, the old school Spurs, than this newfangled 3-point shooting Spurs, because I'm not a believer in this is a 3-point shooting league. That's propaganda that's out. Yes, sir, the snake. That's propaganda that's put out there so some of these white boys can keep jobs. It's a 3-point shooting league. It's a 3-point shooting league. No, it's not. It's a shot hitting league. Watch the Golden State Warriors. I've been saying this for 3 years now. Watch the damn Golden State Warriors. Golden State Warriors don't shoot all threes. The Golden State Warriors execute offense. As Coach Jimmy Fields used to say, shout out to my coach Jimmy Fields, all the plays work, B. All of them. It's about executing. The Golden State Warriors execute their offense with impeccable precision. That's why they win. If it's a 3-point shooting lead, where's everybody else Steph Curry? Where's everybody else Klay Thompson? Everybody don't have one of those. And they got two generational shooters on their team. The whole damn world don't have that. If everybody in the league had a comparable shooter to Steph Curry, then it'd be a 3-point shooting lead. It's only a 3-point shooting lead because y'all want to keep some of these white boys some jobs. Let's be honest. That's it. Yeah, I believe you, man. Dude, it's dope. I'm telling you, man, the Spurs are going to be playing some real defense. They're going to get DeMar DeRozan to play some defense. They're going to be all right, man. Trust me. I don't know if they're going to be championship caliber because y'all still got Casper the Friendly Ghost, a.k.a. LaMarcus Aldridge on the team, the invisible man when it counts. Why the hell did they sign Pau Gasol to that extension? Question number two. But with Greg Popovich and them young boys, that young point guard, he gonna get a chance to flourish. He plays like a pure point guard. He sets the pace of a game. People, the Spurs are not gonna fall off. They ain't gonna fall off a skateboard. Don't wait for it. I'm telling you. Don't wait for it. Shout out to Run DMC. That's a Run DMC lyric, y'all. Your boy hip hop all day long. Hip hop 24/7, 365. But back to the point I was making, it's not a 3-point lead. Follow the Golden State Warriors blueprint. They execute. That's why they're successful. They're successful because they execute. And when you execute, it looks like a 3-point shooting team. The Golden State Warriors are a veteran team. And even when they didn't have NBA experience, most of those guys had college experience. Klay Thompson, he had the game because his dad gave him the game after 2 years of college. You got Steph Curry, who stayed a year of college to become a better ball player. 4 years in college for the homie Draymond. Iguodala, he was a superstar at one point. These are people who had coaches who taught them how to execute. That's why the Golden State Warriors kick everybody draws in their ass. It ain't about them damn threes. Because remember, them first 2 years, Steph was putting it on the floor, blowing past your goof ass. He was doing the damn thing, man. So stop falling for the hype. It's not that. They execute. And then when they execute, then you come down and you shoot a three after Steph then drain one. And then you miss. And then Klay hit one and you miss. And then KD get fouled going to the hole. And he shoot 90% from the free throw. And now they score 9. And your dumb ass then miss 3 shots and you down 14. See, that's how the Dubs beat you. Man, this is checkers, not chess. Basketball is, guess what, people? If it's a 3-point shooting lead, if your black ass or your white ass or your Asian ass or whatever ass y'all, if you learn how to hit some damn free throws in a mid-range shot and drive to the hole, when you get fouled and you hit a shot, that's 3 points too. Okay, I've been saying it for 3 years. If you want to slow down that Golden State Warrior train, make them move their feet, make them play defense. When you move your feet, you lose a little energy. Instead of jumping 14 inches off the ground for your jump shot, you jump 13 and a half, 12. When you jump 13 and a half, 12, then you take an excellent shooter like Steph, you make him a great. You take a great shooter like Klay, you make him a good. And that's how you beat him. Otherwise, exactly. Kevin Durant is a nuclear weapon. They got the cold. They unleash them on you. But even with, Angry Black, even with that, man, How about this? They still almost lost. You know why they lost, in my opinion? They almost lost because these dumbass guys in the NBA, why the hell would you shoot 27 three-pointers? Explain. You a ball player, Doc. Explain to me why somebody would shoot that many threes in a row and miss it. At what point does it click in your head, drive to the hole? And see, everybody who know me know James Harden, my favorite player. But that man needs to go to the Wizard. I'm telling you now. He needs to go to the Wizard to get him some hard. That man was shook. He's been shook the last 2 years. They was, that's, thank you, Ant. Thank you, big Ant. 17th in the league and 3-point attempts. It's not a 3-point shooting league. They execute. They are coached well. They play well. It's a system, and they are operating it. They are the Golden State Warriors. They are the San Francisco 49ers. They're the Dallas Cowboys before Jimmy Johnson left. They are the Lakers. They are the Celtics. They are every, exactly, missed 27 threes, lost by 9. They could have won just by driving to the hole. That's why all you haters of Carmelo Anthony talking about that man is going to be the end of the Houston Rockets. Guess what? You're not missing 27 shots in a row with Melo on the floor because James Harden going to get shook again. And then what's going to happen? He's going to get that ball to Melo. Melo going to put it on you, man. Melo going to put it on you, man. 42.3 threes a game. That's dumb as hell. The Warriors linchpin towards greatness when they hide you. Amen. Speak on it. Speak on it, Saint. Speak on it, Saint. Exactly. That's another thing. Hey, that's another thing. Because to echo the homie Saint's opinions, the Golden State Warriors, they, one of the biggest decisions that they didn't make was to get Kevin Love out of Minnesota for Klay Thompson. Because if they would have got Klay Thompson, it would have been a whole different situation. Houston Rockets, age wrapped the Houston Rockets lost because the guy they bought for sick damn sick was in streets called CP3. Yeah, no. I'm not saying. What I'm saying, Angry Black, is this. Of course, that goes without saying. But they could have still won if my favorite player, the biggest sissy in town, would have drove to the hole. How are you the dude with the most free throws over the attempted over the last 3 years? Don't drive to the hole and make them go to stay where we foul you. You're an 80, 85, 86% free throw shooter. Game over. You lose by 9 after missing 27 shots. You are, y'all 30% retarded. Y'all, that's all I got to say. Y'all 30% retarded. That's all I'm saying. No. It's more than obvious. Without Chris, the absence of the homie Chris Paul did them in. That goes without saying. But I'm telling you, I think they still could have won. The Golden State Warriors were reeling. And while they were reeling, they had a chance to do it. They had a chance to beat them. I honestly believe people think Melo is going to be their demise, but that's not going to be their demise. CP3 would have made those clowns. Yes, that's a, yep. Speak on it, man. Speak on it. That's exactly what I'm talking about, man. Man, I'm enjoying this first show on Spreaker, man. I'm having a ball. You know what? This is one of the things that I like about the Spreaker family. I'm gonna take me a break. I'll be back in about 2 minutes, man. Holler at your boy.
Wish that I could fit in these expensive jeans. I don't like this cut. blood. It's like the Lord got my order wrong. 3 a.m. stress eating, laying down on it. Now your blood sugar is borderline waterlogged. Seen them rise, I seen them fall. I seen the dreams of fiends and scenes of war inside my mind. It ain't nothing serene. It's called blackness, the most expensive gene of all.
For you to compete against, calm down, listen to a brother who knows. Cause the calm down, listen to a brother who knows. Cause the calm down, listen to a brother who knows. Cause it doesn't make sense for you to compete against. Calm down, listen to America's
best. Ladies and gentlemen, haters and better friends, your man is back in full effect. It's the end of the bench show. Holler at your boy. Hey, the homie Saint just said Jerry West builds championships, teams. Now West is with the Clippers. Most definitely, man, Jerry West is the man. There's nothing, you cannot say anything bad about Jerry West. It's going to be that, you know what? Basketball in Los Angeles is about to be off the chain, man. You got one of the better coaches in the league and can relate to the players and Doc Rivers. You got one of the best executives in league history, Jerry West. Magic Johnson is building his reputation. It's going to be special, man. If you don't believe that, hey, man, miss the boat, man. You know what? I always revert back to what Barry Lamont Bond said, and that is, if you don't appreciate what I'm doing, when this is over, you'll just be able to say you missed the party. And that's what people are going to do. They will miss the party in regards to Magic Johnson, Jerry West. It's going to be they're going to be scrapping. It's going down. It's going to be a motherfucker, man. I'm telling you. Now that we have Steve Nash in the front office, it's been for two seasons, Jerry West is champion. Yeah, man, it's going down, man. Los Angeles basketball is about to be something special. And if you guys don't see it, comment, y'all gonna miss out on it, man. Stop listening to these clowns on this damn, on these major networks. All they doing is continuing to get you to listen. They don't know no more than me. They don't know more than the man Angry Black. They don't know more than any of us, man. We know exactly what they know. They just got a little bit of money and trying to put the chat room dudes, Luke Walton made the entire Lakers season. Angry Black got a question. Do y'all think Luke Walton gonna make it through the season? I actually do, man. I believe that LeBron James sanctions that move. I honestly do. I do. The homie S says yes. Nobody else has chimed in. Joe said he doubted. But I believe that it is a LeBron James sanctioned move. Genie Buss, the owner, likes him. I actually like him. And a fun fact, the homie LeBron James, the Los Angeles Lakers had, I think, the third best record in all of the NBA. Last year, yes, yeah, exactly. What Big Ann said, they showed improvement every year. They had the second or third best record in the NBA from the second half of the season last year. That means they were hitting on all cylinders. And let's not forget Lonzo and them. What up, man? Hey, another show, y'all. Barbershop Sports Talk Podcast came on last night. Y'all gotta check it out, man. Subscribe to these people, man. We trying to build a community. We trying to make your voice heard on a regular basis. Thank you for joining the show. We having a ball as usual. We getting down. We getting it in. Man, follow these people, brothers. We are trying to make a voice for the voiceless. But like I was saying, what I was about to get into is this. The U.S. Open is in full effect right now. But I'm going to take it back to the French Open. What people are not realizing is we are in the midst of a renaissance in regards to black athletes. If you don't notice, a lot more brothers are on the PGA Tour. A lot more sisters are in in professional tennis.